Peter James is here to talk about his mother, who was a refugee just before the war. Hello, Peter.
Hi.
Hi. Your mother had a very interesting story. She actually became a famous glove maker. Did she tell you about her early years, or did she not?
No, my mother, Cornelia, kept her entire Jewish background completely silent. As far as I knew, she was a Catholic. And the first I knew that my mom was a Jew was when I went to Charter House and I was 13 years old and I was a boarder. My first week at school, 10 guys sat on a wall as I walked back to my boarding house and they went Jew, Jew, Jew at me. And I thought, who are they talking to? I thought it must be somebody else. And the next day I was walking back from class, again, the same time of day, the same 10 guys sat on that wall, Jew, Jew, Jew. And I went back to my boarding house and I phoned my mother from a payphone and I said, are we Jewish? And she was really awkward silence. I said, no, darling, but we have a little bit of Jewish blood way back in the family. And the same thing happened the next day, and I jumped over the wall, grabbed one of the guys, and punched his lights out. And that stopped for me. But for the rest of my teens, I did everything I could to be a white Anglo-Saxon Protestant.
But your mother obviously had a reason why she didn't tell you. What do you think went through her mind? I mean, she was safe, she was successful.
What happened was I had my first successful novel came out in 1987, and the Daily Mail did a big piece on me, and they said, you know, what do you attribute your talent to? And I said, well, whatever I have, I've inherited from my mother, because she arrived as a penniless refugee from Austria in 1938 with nothing but Juden stamped in her passport and a suitcase full of gloving leathers. She'd been studying glove design at Vienna Art College. She worked in the war doing occupational therapy, teaching soldiers to get their hands moving again by making gloves. And then at the end of the war, she realized that there were no nice clothes around. There were all these gray, drab, demob suits. And she dyed a range of gloves in 100 shades of color. And Vogue picked up on this and they called her the Color Queen of England. And instantly she came to the attention of the two big couturiers at the time, which was Norman Hartnell and Hardy Amos. And they, I think Amos was, Hartnell was making the going away, the dress, going away dress for Princess Elizabeth, now the Queen's wedding in 1947, and asked my mum to make the gloves. And that was it. She shot to fame. And my dad, who was very English, brought up a lapsed Anglican, was a chartered accountant, and they suddenly, my mum had 400 employees and my dad joined her and they shared an office for the rest of her life. And then in 1987, I was very openly talking about it. I was proud about it. And then this big double page spread in the Daily Mail on my novel that came out back then. And they said, what did you attribute this to? And I said, well, my mum, probably I got some of her talent, luckily. And I told the story, and at 10 o'clock in the morning, the day the paper came out, my phone rang and it was my mum. And I was expecting her to say, wonderful article, darling, well done. She said, why have you told the whole world we're Jewish? I said, mum, come on, I'm 40 years old and I'm proud of it. I've got nothing to, and I said, why do you hide it?
Exactly, because it's not that she was embarrassed about being Jewish, but there must have been some deep psychological issue.
Yeah, there was, and I didn't find it out until she was in 1999, when she was terminally ill with cancer and she was in the martlets. And I tried to encourage her because she'd never told her life story. So I went and I bought her a little Sony dictaphone. And I said, please, just dictate. And I went back the next day. She said, oh, I've done 3 chapters. And I said, fantastic. I'll listen to it at home. So I take it home and I listen to it. It says, well, I was born in Vienna. And in 1938, we had Kristallnacht and we all had to get out. And I came to England and started teaching soldiers how to make gloves. Now, the way you make a glove is that you need to have a particular fit with a thumb, which is called a bolt. I went back. I said, mum, this is not what I want to hear. I want to hear what happened? You know, how did your family all get out? How did it emotionally affect you? And then she said, I really want to apologize to you for being Jewish. And I just burst into tears. And I said, what do you mean? I said, it's given me probably the best breaks of my life. And I said, why have you hidden it all your life? She said, two reasons. She said, firstly, I was afraid that the Nazis would rise up again and you kids would be better off not knowing and safer not knowing. And she said, and secondly, I was trying to build a business in England in the late 40s, early 1950s. And not many people realize just how anti-Semitic England was. I had two things against me. I had the fact that I was a woman in business back then, and the fact that I was a Jew.
Peter, one more thing. You were quoted as saying that you owe a lot of your drive and ambition and creativity to your mother.
Undoubtedly, my mum had tremendous drive. I can remember I used to go work in the factory as a kid in Brighton. It was in the middle of Brighton in Havelock Road. And she would wear this white cloak, you know, very sort of official. And I was so proud of her. And also, my God, when I started my writing career, I mean, if you'd sat next to her on a plane or a train, she would start talking to you, talk to anybody. And by the time you got off that train, you'd go straight to the nearest bookshop and buy every book of mine you could find. She was extraordinary. She was a force of nature. She charmed people. And I think the other part was those guys that sat on the wall. And it didn't finish for me completely at Charterhouse. So I had other people. I said, you know, little Jew boy, you're never going to make any success, are you? And I still hear those words. And that I think made me more determined than ever that little Jew boy here would try and make a success.
Peter, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you so much. And thanks for doing this program. It's a great thing you're doing.